espécie do anjo Ismael. Glória a Deus nas alturas, paz aos homens na terra. Jesus, bom e amado Mestre, sustenta os teus humildes irmãos pecadores nas lutas deste mundo. Anjo bendito do Senhor, abre para nós os teus compassivos braços. Abriga-nos do mal. Levanta os nossos espíritos à majestade do teu reino. E infunde em todos os nossos sentidos a luz do teu imenso amor. Jesus, pelo teu sublime sacrifício, pelos teus martírios na cruz, dá a esses que se acham ligados ao pesado fardo da matéria, orientação perfeita do caminho da virtude, o único pelo qual podemos te encontrar. Jesus, paz a eles, misericórdia aos nossos inimigos, e recebe em teu seio bendito a prece dos últimos dos teus servos. Bendita estrela, farol das imortais falanges, purifica-nos com os teus raios divinos, lava-nos de todas as culpas, atrai-nos para junto do teu seio, santuário bendito de todos os amores. Se o mundo com seus erros, paixões e ódios alastra o caminho de espinhos, escurecendo o nosso horizonte com as trevas do pecado, rebrilha mais com a tua misericórdia, para que seguros e apoiados no teu evangelho, possamos trilhar e vencer as escabrosidades do carreiro e chegar às moradas do teu reino. Amiga estrela, farol dos pecadores e dos justos, abre o teu seio divino e recebe a nossa súplica pela humanidade inteira. Assim seja.
Listen with the ear of your heart. Welcome, my beautiful brothers and sisters, connecting from all over Mother Earth to the portal of the Casa de Don Ignacio, the House of Love, where the medicine is love, here in Abidjania, in the heart of Brazil. And we have another spectacular day here, this gift from God, to learn these difficult lessons. We have come here on earth to learn in these physical bodies. And the clouds are back in force, passing slowly, white, fluffy, gorgeous clouds, reminding us of our impermanence and that we are just travelers here on earth. And all of this will pass. And we have beyond permanently the deep blue sky, reminding us of the mantle of our Mother Mary, her protection and her love for each and every one of us, her children. And this morning in the valley was just phenomenal, with flocks of array azules, these majestic big blue birds with multicolored underbellies flying in formation overhead. And I spotted a few toucans, their yellow beaks shining in the morning sunshine, And I was fascinated by the intricate design of the spider webs glistening in the morning sunshine. It was just so wonderful to be embraced by all of creation. And we are in such gratitude for this wonderful interconnection with all of Mother Nature, and that we're all resonating and vibrating with these gifts that we have received from God Almighty. And gratitude is the food of the Christ consciousness. So let's be grateful for this wonderful day. And as we settle deeper and deeper into this divine work, wherever you are, be as comfortable as you possibly can. If you're lying on a crystal bed, enjoying the high vibration of the Casa crystals, this is great. If you prefer to sit upright with our heads elevated just a little, so this energy can flow fluidly, freely and easily through each and every one of us, like a river, a current of love and light. And if you remember to put a glass of water beside you, water is life. Our bodies are over 70% water. It will be blessed, and we will drink it at the end of the work to nourish us, mind, body and spirit, to help us on our journeys on Earth. So let's close our physical eyes now and open our spiritual eyes, where we can see everything beyond appearances, all there is. And we are reminded again and again that we are not the body, we're so much more. We move in and out of perishable bodies. Our bodies merely house our eternal spirits. And these vehicles of clay have been lent to us by Mother Earth to walk the path of the light. And when our earthly days are finished, we will be liberated out of these vehicles of clay into our true home beyond the veil. Today we celebrate Saint Benedict. An Italian 6th century abbot, historically known as the father of Western monasticism. And what is so special about Saint Benedict is that he is an entity of the Casa di Don Ignacio. And some of you may remember there was a small statue of him in the first current room. And he is such a good help to all of us struggling to find the good in these hard days on earth. Saint Benedict works with the entire team of entities, the Falange of Dom Ignacio, Dr. Augusto de Almeida, who will go to the depths to save one soul, Angel Ishmael, whom you heard his prayer at the beginning of the work. And all of these magnificent entities help us to lift our spirits to the majesty of the Kingdom of Heaven. And of course, as the Casa is one of the biggest deobsession houses in the world, these entities are helping us in the fight between the good and the darker forces on earth. And Saint Benedict, like many saints, was from a wealthy background, and he was a twin. His sister became a saint also, Sister Scholastica, and both of them surrendered their substantial material wealth to walk the path of the light. There were so many miracles with Saint Benedict in his lifetime. He is the patron of Europe, and also he's the patron of school children and students. And of course, we're all students of life. He's also the patron of kidney disease, monks, and poisoning. And he became a hermit in the 6th century when morality was at an all-time low. Just like this world we live in now, not a lot has changed. And word of Saint Benedict's holiness spread, and many ascetics sought him out for leadership. Benedict said his lifestyle would be too much and too strict for them. And of course, many insisted and eventually became so envious they tried to poison his drink. But when he prayed a blessing over the cup of poison, it shattered. He was also tried to be poisoned by bread. There was so much jealousy because he was such a pure spirit. And of course, a raven came down and took the bread away from him, saving him. So we're in great hands with Saint Benedict. He wrote his famous rule of life, which emphasizes work, simplicity, and hospitality, unifying us all. The motto of the Benedictine order is to seek to do battle for Jesus, to multiply the Christ consciousness on earth. The rule of the Benedictines, the rule of life, helps us to live a full and holy life. It embodies the love of Christ and the love of our neighbours, the teachings of the Gospel of Jesus. It helps us with stability and simplicity, stewardship, which is the respectful use of material things for the good of all. The Benedictines are also multiplying the high vibration of hospitality, saying that all guests shall be welcomed as Christ. The Benedictine rule embraces community and unity, justice and peace, and also conversion to the likeness of Christ. They had a great work ethic. They multiplied humility, and they were big on discipline. And Saint Benedictine was known for his dedication to prayer, reminding us to keep our prayers short, sweet, and from the heart. Saint Benedict particularly liked the Lord's Prayer, not only because of its powerful protection from the darker forces, but especially because it encourages us to forgive ourselves and others, which is the key to liberation. So with this beautiful high vibration in our hearts, with the help of our brother, Saint Benedict, let us pray the Lord's Prayer given to us by our brother Jesus. And as always, before we pray, forgive. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Rather, deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, now and forever. Amen. And to our Divine Mother Mary, the Mother's Heart, the feminine power, Mother Earth, Queen of Peace, we ask you now in this sacred moment to intercede for us, your children, to somehow alleviate the suffering of humanity, especially now in these turbulent days on earth. And to help us to find the peace, the harmony, the tranquility, the love, the forgiveness, the joy, the gratitude, the humility deep, deep within us. And it is within all of us. We are divine beings, helping us all on our healing journey back home, merging into the light, out of separation, into oneness. One heart, one soul, one light, one love. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us children now and at the hour of our passing. Amen.
Washed by
a little.
vibration. And God speaks to us always and in all ways. We need to open our hearts and receive the word of God. Saint Benedict reminds us to listen with the ear of your heart. And in these quieter days on earth, we really need to take time out. If we can, go into Mother Nature and just sit and just be. Some of us are lucky enough to have a park nearby us, or have a garden even. Silence is not empty, it is full of answers. Sometimes it's better to talk to God just with our hearts. You may remember in the casa, there was a sign on the wall saying, "Silence is a prayer." We can pray in silence. Sometimes the best form of prayer is when we have run out of things to say. The fruit of silence is prayer. The fruit of prayer is faith. The fruit of faith is love. The fruit of love is service. Of service is peace. Amen. glorious high vibration of the Christ consciousness working with all of these beautiful entities of the casa. Let's become conscious of our breathing. Slow, gentle, deep, deep breaths into the heart center, the center of our being. Allowing the breath to maintain our equilibrium. As we are in gratitude to God Almighty for this gift of life that we have been given. Breathing in more and more and more divine light from the everlasting source of all light. Permitting this beautiful love light to penetrate our very being here now in this moment, mind, body, spirit, nourishing us. Giving us everything we need and much, much more to walk the path of the light in these difficult days on earth. Remembering this beautiful light, becoming this love light as the beautiful light beings that we truly are, shining brightly in the dark. And with each precious breath pouring forth from our open hearts, filling Mother Earth with a highly vibrational, strong, sure, pure, crystal clear divine love light. Showering a gift of purification, illumination, transformation. Upon all beings, carnate and disincarnate. In and around Mother Earth in this moment. All that matters when we get to the end of these earthly lives is how much did we love. And all of these great elevated beings, these saints, these entities are helping us to multiply the Christ consciousness on earth, which is love, in the teachings of our brother Jesus. Love one another as I have loved you. Love your neighbor who doesn't look like you, think like you, love like you, speak like you, pray like you, vote like you. Love your neighbor, no exceptions. Love, loving, love. us relax into our physical bodies now. Taking a long, deep breath. Our hard work is over for now. We are open to receive. As you give, so it will be given you. We are now receiving a deep, deep, deep cleansing from on high into our open hearts. This is a unique opportunity to let go of all denser energies that no longer serve us. Not only from this lifetime, but indeed past lifetimes, known or unknown to us, as we surrender all of our problems, our anxieties, our fears, our pain, our hurt, our anger, anything that seems unsurmountable in these unsure days. All of our grudges, our resentments, our lack of gratitude, our lack of humility. Let's surrender it all over to our Creator, the Architect of the Cosmos, transmuting all of this denser energy into divine light as we become unburdened, lighter, happier, healthier, stronger, more at peace and harmony with all of creation, of which each and every one of us is an integral part of. In our mind's eye now, let's visualize a waterfall like the waterfall here at the Casa, or any place of sacred running water that you know, with all the gifts of Mother Nature. Birds of paradise, serenading us in a divine symphony. Perhaps you can hear the birds here now. This is beautiful. Big blue butterflies helping us with our transformation. Strong green oak trees purifying our oxygen. Carpets of magnificent, colourful, fragrant flowers, being kissed by bumblebees and hummingbirds. Brilliant sunshine and crystal clear waters embodying rainbows of light. Let's all go to this beautiful place together. Bring your family and friends with you. And hard and all as it may seem, bring those you need to forgive and those who need to forgive you. We've never had more help to do this work of liberation. Now is the time. There is a reason why we're back here on Earth, to do this deep work of cleansing and healing. And let's bring into this high vibration anyone who is particularly struggling in these challenging days. Anyone who is depressed, suicidal, desolate, who's feeling isolated or abandoned, the homeless, and anyone who is lucky enough to have a home and who is making their way back there right now. And we send out a shout out to our brothers and sisters who are working in the travel industry, who are helping to bring our brothers and sisters home. It's a very stressful time on Earth. And let's bring our brother, Medium Chuao, into this high vibration. And anyone who has suffered or who is suffering on account of the problems at the Casa. And we never forget our brothers and sisters without their physical bodies, who are making their way home into the light, extending this beautiful cleansing healing energy to them also. Every being deserves to be liberated, whether we have a body or not. And as we receive this magnificent, glorious high vibration into our open hearts, let's share it with the world, allowing it to pour forth into all hospitals, helping our angel doctors and nurses, healthcare professionals, and anyone who's in a caring capacity on Mother Earth in these pivotal times. Allowing it to pour forth now into nursing homes, helping our elders, hospices, orphanages, prisons, asylums, migrant camps, having to liberate our brothers and sisters, recognizing that we're all God's children. Anywhere, everywhere on planet Earth now that our brothers and sisters are suffering or are hungry or in pain, bringing forth this cleansing healing energy into all war zones. Anywhere there is conflict, disharmony, fighting, riots, bringing peace in our lifetime. Remembering the words of Saint Rita of Cassia, to God all things are possible. This pristine high vibration gushing forth into the consciousness of our government leaders and anyone who's in a position of authority or another human being, helping them to wake up to our divinity, to make good decisions about this planet for our future, for generations to come, to put people before profit. This crystal clear energy now gushing forth into all of our ecosystems, regenerating, regrowing, renewing, refreshing, nourishing. Already Mother Earth is bouncing back. Hallelujah. Praise God. And in this sacred moment now, this gorgeous high vibration enveloping Gaia, growing, expanding, multiplying, cleansing and healing all beings as it gushes forth into infinity. May all beings be happy and at peace. Amen. these precious moments now, when our hearts are filled to overflowing with God's love for us, His children. We are in total gratitude to God Almighty for yet another day to learn these hard lessons we have come here on earth to learn, knowing that we are not alone. And God has sent so many elevated beings, ascended masters, angels, archangels, guardian angels, and these beautiful entities of light and love with us every step of this journey. Thank you for helping us to become awakened to the bigger picture, to see beyond appearances all there is. And through the power of our brother, Saint Benedict, to be able to multiply the Christ consciousness on earth, which is love. Love is all there is. Love never ends. And we are love and we are light. And thank you, as always, to our beautiful brother, Jesus, Prince of Peace, and our Divine Mother Mary, Queen of Peace, reminding us from the blue of the sky, her mantle is always protecting us and loving us, and that we are united by the sky. The sky is the daily bread of our eyes. Whether it be the blue sky or the starry night sky, and Jesus and Mary, their sacred hearts are beaming out their love light to us on earth. And when we are liberated from this valley of tears, we will be welcomed home into their loving arms. And to you, my beautiful brothers and sisters, for your willingness to love and to serve in all things for the greater glory of God, we are awakened on this difficult path now. God sees every effort, and we're doing the best we can. So never give up. We are greatly loved and supported by all of these majestic beings available to us 24/7. Your faith will heal you and those around you, and your love and your light are changing the world forever for the better. Congratulations and thank you. Let us pray. We ask that only the light of God shine through, that the light of Jesus and Mary dissolve all darkness, the light of the Christ consciousness dissolve all darkness, the fire of the Holy Spirit dissolve all darkness, The light of God is my strength, my power, my highest vibration, my transformative power. The presence of God's light within me is my strength. Amen. Love, loving, love. Namaste.